Hello everyone, my name is Bethany and this is my channel, Bethany's Thoughts. Today I am doing a video on my favorite fairy tale retellings. So if you've seen me rant and rave about Ella Enchanted at all and all my Disney readathons I've participated, you should know that I'm a big fan of fairy tales. And I'm wearing the shirt for this video to commemorate that. It's one of my favorites. And I met my husband in fairy tales class. This is no joke. This is true life. So obviously fairy tales are a thing for me. Always have been. I always gravitated to fairy tales and always found them really interesting and always found them retellings of them especially really interesting. So these are some of my favorites. I kind of picked from my top ratings. I've read several over the years, but these are like my top of the things that I've read over the years. And then there's a range of middle grade, YA, and a couple adult. I definitely feel like when I was growing up, fairy tale retellings, you know, you had Disney and that was basically it. You didn't really get anything else. And I feel like now you trip over fairy tale retellings every day of the week. They're much more popular than they used to be when I was growing up. So I'm behind some of the times of some of the retellings that have come out since then. But these are some of the ones that I've liked and some of them are older. I hope that's okay. But hopefully it's just to help you discover something that you didn't know. To get started, I'm going to start with middle grade and then go up in age from there. So to start off, I mean, obviously we're going to start off with the number one, my original 12-year-old, I mean, the pages are so yellow, my original 12-year-old copy of Ella Enchanted that I have reread several times and it's pretty decent, still in pretty decent condition. This is by Kale Carson Levine, a retelling of Cinderella. It is about Ella and Char, and Ella has put a favor on her, a gift on her, that she always has to be obedient. She is forced to be obedient in certain situations that she does not want to be, and is put in a situation where when she starts to fall for the prince, that the prince might come to danger under because of her gift. So it's just about her adventure. It's a really great retelling. The world building is really great. Read the prequel recently, Ogre Enchanted, and it was still amazing. So this is still one of my favorite books of all time in life. And it still holds up to this day. I love it. I love it so much. Definitely number one of my number one retellings for sure. The next book that I loved growing up and also middle grade is called Just Ella by Margaret Peterson Haddix. This is what happens to Cinderella after she gets the prince. And it's not what you would think. So it is somewhat of a, not necessarily a full retelling, but it is like a reimagining of Cinderella. I haven't read that one in a while. Ellen Chen and I reread it recently, but I just remember really liking that one. That one always sticks with me. When I think of Ella Enchanted, I think of also Just Ella. They go, I think I read them really closely around the same time, so they kind of exist in my head in the same space. It's not what you can think. She realizes that maybe she doesn't like it there and also starts to fall for somebody else who isn't the prince. One of the things that I like about Ella and Ella Enchanted and Ella and Just Ella is both of these heroines are really strong, really independent, and essentially both of them kind of save themselves. They're not damsels in distress. I think that really inspired me to look for books that had characters like that and influenced my reading from then on out. I think for a middle grade book to have strong heroines, it was really, really important. Let's move on to YA. The next book that I recommend that I love for fairy tale retellings, one of my favorite Rapunzel retelling of all time, is called Zelle by Donna Jo Napoli. She also has a couple other fairy tale retellings. Zelle was my all-time favorite. What I like about Zelle is, first of all, it's still told in first-person present. I never read that type of narrative style before when I was growing up, and I still remember that, and it still struck me. But if it's not your thing, just go into it knowing that it's written that way. But what I really liked about Zelle is that it switches from perspectives. You get the prince's perspective, you get Zelle's perspective, and then you also get the witch's perspective, which I thought the witch's perspective was especially fascinating. And so when Tangled came out, I was super here for it because I was thinking about Zelle the whole time. Donna Jo Napoli's writing is really, really beautiful, and I just thought it was a really solid Rapunzel retelling, and it got me really into Rapunzel from then on out. I've read several since then, but this one is still one of my favorites. The next book that I recommend, so Okay, so to start off with, this was a whole series. It was called Once Upon a Time series. It wasn't necessarily a series that went in chronological order. It was a series of books that were fairy tale retellings. And they started coming out when I was in high school, and then I think they had like 20-something books, and then even continued publishing in college, and I still bought them when I was in college, even though they were starting to get very juvenile for my age range. I was low-key obsessed with the series so much. The retellings are all really, really good. I really liked all of the retellings, but I think I've listed two of my favorites. One of them was called Sunlight and Shadow by Cameron Doki. That was a retelling of The Magic Flute, which is an opera. I've never seen the opera Magic Flute. I'm not much of an opera goer. I love theater, but I've never gone to an opera before. But this retelling was so beautifully told, and it made me get really, really into what the Magic Flute was even about. I really, really enjoyed that particular retelling. The next one I really liked, that was also my favorite, was Snow by Tracy Lynn. A really unique, interesting retelling of Snow White. Once Upon a Time series, a lot of them are out of print, but I think I've come across one or two reprintings, which has me low-key intrigued if they're trying to bring them back. I don't know. Interestingly enough, Cameron Doki wrote quite a few of them, of that particular series, and she's continued to rewrite the Disney Twisted Tales that are like the YA movie reimaginings. I haven't read any of those, but I had a couple of them, so hopefully maybe I'll get to them soon. Yeah, I think a lot of these are out of print. I don't know if they're available. Maybe you can buy them super, super cheap on Amazon. My next YA favorite retelling is going to be the Lunar Chronicle series by Marissa Meyer. This is the first book called Cinder, which is obviously Cinderella. And then it follows Scarlet, Cress, and Winter. Scarlet is Red Riding Hood, Cress is Rapunzel, and Winter is Snow White. They are a sci-fi fairy tale retelling. It's like fairy tales meet Star Wars. And I wouldn't think I would love that. Not that I'm not a Star Wars fan, but I don't think those two things would work. But in this series, it works really well. And it's also dystopian. And there's just so many good things about it. I had the first book for a while. I don't remember. I got it somewhere free at a con, maybe. I get a lot of my books that way. Then I read it and I was obsessed, and then I read the next three books in the series. Cinder, which is the retelling of Cinderella, and Cress, which is the retelling of Rapunzel, are my two favorites. They're just super delightful. I also, as a dystopian series, I really like the dystopian society that they're in. It's really fascinating, really interesting. Marissa Meyer brings a lot of science into it. I strongly recommend the series. It's one of my favorite YA series of all time. I don't think people love it as much as I do, but I love it. And just for fairy retellings, just how she reimagines them, I think is really, really interesting and is a really unique take, and I appreciate it for that reason as well. The next fairy tale retelling that is one of my favorites is Cruel Beauty by Rosamund Hodge. This is a Beauty and the Beast retelling. Also a little bit of a Bluebeard retelling. I don't know if anyone's familiar with Bluebeard. It's not a well-known fairy tale. Disney's not making a movie about this one. Bluebeard, for those who don't know, is a fairy tale man who is named Bluebeard, who gets a young woman to become his bride, and in doing so, the woman who arrives realizes when she arrives that he has several dead wives in his basement or attic. The story changes depending on the retelling or depending on the fairy tale. Several different endings happen for the fairy tale. Either she kills him, either she saves the wives, or she ends up dead herself. So it just kind of depends on which version you read. So yeah, so Cruel Beauty has a Bluebeard vibe to me because he is like a prince in the castle and he has to get a new wife every year. And the heroine of the character is like sent to the castle and she's like the next person on like the slaughter. Like she's the next sacrificial lamb for this, you know, character. So it's kind of got Bluebeard vibes to me, but also very strongly Beauty and the Beast as well. It was a really interesting and different take on Beauty and the Beast, and I really enjoyed it. And it was very different than what a Beauty and the Beast retelling that I've read previously. So I really enjoyed that one. I really liked the heroine from that one too. I don't know, she just was really strong. You know, she was the character that turned the tide and broke the curse, and not in a way you would expect. it was different and it was interesting, and I really liked that it was a different retelling that I had read previously. She also has a book called Crimson Bound that I believe is a Red Riding Hood retelling. I have not read it, but I've heard also really good things about that one too. The next book as my favorite fairy tale retellings is Entwined by Heather Walwerk Dixon. Now, I haven't seen this book nearly anywhere. It came out a few. This is actually one of the newer ones out of some of these selections. It came out, I want to say, about 5 years ago. It is a 12 Dancing Princesses retelling, which is not a fairy tale that you see retold very often, which I can really appreciate. For those who don't know 12 Dancing Princesses, it's also not as well-known fairy tale. 12 Dancing Princesses is when 12 princesses keep going out and sneaking out in the middle of the night to go dancing, and the king gives a reward to anyone who can discover what his daughters are doing in the middle of the night and ruining their dancing shoes every night. He will basically give them a reward of marrying one of his daughters. So, and then of course he figures it out, and of course she marries one of the daughters. Anyway, that one's pretty consistent in tellings from the ones that I've read. I really appreciate this retelling because in the fairy tale itself, the girls are very passive, and Entwined, I feel like the girls are very active, and you actually see the guy who, I don't remember if he's a prince or not, but the guy who basically figures out what they're doing and the lead, or the oldest daughter, actually really form a genuine connection instead of her being like the reward for like figuring out what happens to their dancing shoes or whatever. And there's also like a whole like element of a curse happening and why that's happening. It was a lot magical. It was more magical. There was a lot more of a backstory to it and a reason for why the daughters keep going dancing. So it was interesting. It was different. I really enjoyed it. And unique, because like I said, 12 Dancing Princesses is not a retelling that you get very often. I enjoyed it. I thought it was a lot of fun. So now moving on to my adult picks. The first adult pick I have is going to be, I think this is a really popular one because I know a lot of people really like her, Beauty by Robin McKinley. This is a Beauty and the Beast retelling. It's called Beauty. And I want to make sure, I think the one that I like is called Beauty, but she actually has two. There's one, I think, that's called something about Rose. I want to say it's Rose. If I find it, I'll put like a picture or a cover or something. I haven't read the second one. Beauty's the oldest. I want to say that one she came out with in the 80s or early 90s. I would say it's like the most like straightforward retelling of Beauty and the Beast, and definitely more of like a fantasy take on it. But it was just so well told, and I really, really enjoyed it. I think that, you know, Beauty is a really strong character. I think it was just really straightforward and also just really simply and beautifully told. I really enjoyed that one. I think I rated that one 4 or 5 stars. So, and then last but not least, one of my favorite fairy tale retellings of all time is going to be The Fairy Godmother by Mercedes Lackey from the 500 Kingdoms series. I love this book so much. This is a Cinderella retelling, but it's also kind of like a fairy tales tropes in general retelling-ish. So basically in this world, how the world works is there is 500 kingdoms, and they have to follow a magical force that's called the tradition. And the tradition makes these fairy tale events happen. So if there is an evil stepmother with a daughter orphan, then the tradition forces it to like have a prince available for her. So this is about a rejected Cinderella. So since she is in a Cinderella type of situation, but she can't be with the prince because the prince is like a child. So the tradition like doesn't know what to do with her and doesn't really work out for her. Her name is Elena. Elena decides to kind of like make her own path, and she gets recruited by the fairy godmothers. The fairy godmother says, well, you have all this, the tradition magic around you. You can use that to become a fairy godmother to navigate the tradition and help others on their quests or their paths to like navigate the tradition. Because I guess like the buildup of a lot of tradition magic and then not anywhere to go can cause really bad things to happen, or really bad for those with bad fairy tales, not the good fairy tales. So she learns how to become a fairy godmother. In doing so, she meets someone. I want to say he's a seventh son of seven sons, because that's a really popular fairy tale trope. And like, for some reason, it doesn't work out for him. Or he's a sixth son of a seventh son. I can't quite remember what it is, but he's also his own trope. And she meets him, and they start kind of figuring things out together in her role as fairy godmother. So if you like fairy tale retellings at all, and if you like fairy tale tropes at all, it has all the tropes, and it's delightful. There's about four or five other books in the series, I want to say. This one is by far my favorite. It's the funniest. It's clever. It's really, really fun. The other books in the series just aren't as good as this one. I think because it's more like behind the scenes of the tradition, while some of the other fairy tales, they're like in the tradition. So it's not, since she's outside of it, it just gives a whole different perspective. And I like that it's like a subverted retelling, like things don't go according to plan. So it's a lot of fun. So that's my fairy tale retellings. Those are some of my favorites. I hope you learned about a new book that you want to check out, or one that you think sounds like fun and want to look into. Or let me know in the comments if you learned a new book that you want to check out. Or let me know in the comments if there's a fairy tale retelling that's your favorite that I haven't mentioned or that you really, really like. I would love to know. And maybe I will look into checking it out, because my goal, I definitely want to get back more into fairy tale retellings. That's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. See you again soon. Bye.